Hello and welcome to EQ International Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. Today we are in conversation with Mr. Chetan Shah from Solex. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Welcome to EQ.
Thank you.
Sir, could you please introduce your company? Tell us about Solex and its journey so far.
Solex Energy Limited is a listed company on National Stock Exchange. And we are one of the oldest solar panel manufacturers in India. We started manufacturing solar panel in 2017, where there were very few, like three or four manufacturers at that time, 2007. And from 2011, there were many other few manufacturers came up into the business. Solex, basically, you know, we are active in 13 states. We have our projects in 13 states. At present, we have a very small manufacturing at Anand. And we are coming up with a 1.2 gigawatt solar panel manufacturing, which will commence the production by the end of the January 2022. So we are changing, like, you know, the next gear. And we are coming up with all advanced tech, high efficiency solar modules only. So we will start with 540, 550 watt peak and up to 750 watt peak. So this is what will be our product range. And we do have a plan for solar cell manufacturing also, once we are done with the 1.2 gigawatt of solar module. So this is what is our roadmap for coming 2 years in terms of manufacturing of solar equipment.
Talking about manufacturing, what are the current opportunities in the domestic manufacturing sector regarding solar?
Now, it is not only the Indian market, but internationally, European market, if you look at the US customers, everybody is now looking at the Indian manufacturers. People, after learning from this COVID and the monopolistic market from China, now basically all countries, all major developers, they are looking at the Indian manufacturer. And fortunately, all Indian manufacturers now gearing up to produce the high efficiency modules. And within 2 or 3 months time, India will be able to compete with China, because China is the largest producer of solar panel in the world. So there is a direct, I don't say competition, but at least, you know, very strong alternative which is coming up as India for the manufacturer. So there is a bright future for Indian manufacturers, not only in India, but globally.
So what are the challenges that are being faced for solar manufacturing domestically?
Challenges are basically, you know, up till now, the India is dependent in terms of technology, in terms of raw material on China. So we had a very limited things to do, you know, in terms of manufacturing. We were just getting all the raw material from the China, and now we were producing modules in a very limited numbers, not very high efficiency modules, but the outdated models. That was the scenario up till now. The challenge for India is to, because now the worldwide people are looking at Indian manufacturer as their supplier, as the next factory of global supply. So a big challenge is the technology which is available in India, the dependency on China. These are the challenges basically, you know. The manpower who are not trained for the very high tech and high efficiency cells and modules, the equipments, we are still dependent on China. So these are the challenges, and India need to address this. That one is, like, you know, the manufacturing of complete ecosystem, building up ecosystem, manufacturing all the raw material in India, the equipment manufacturing which are used in manufacturing of raw material. So we need to reduce that dependence. So it is a 5 years program, definitely it cannot happen overnight, but these are the challenges and the India needs to overcome this.
So what are the expectations from the policy makers and government to boost manufacturing domestically?
Well, first thing is solar business and renewable energy business. It is too much of, there is a lot of dependency on government. The involvement of government is too much. And, you know, at every corner, there is some dependency on the government. So basically what happens, like people are, the entrepreneurs are unable to take their independent decision. They always look at the policy. They always look at the uncertainty of policy. So first thing what government should do is they should not involve so much in terms of policy making, in terms of the driving down the business. Let business happen as an entrepreneur. Indians are entrepreneurs, so Indians know how to do business.
Mm-hmm.
IT is a business where there is a very less involvement of government, mm-hmm. and it has grown up globally. Now, India is a superpower.
Yeah.
So we do not want government to get involved in each and everything, number one. When it comes to manufacturing, yes, government needs to support Indian manufacturer rather than supporting import. So that is the first thing that needs to be done. China did that. China was not a global factory earlier.
Yeah.
Right? So China, how China became a global factory?
Mm-hmm.
Government supported all the manufacturing from the backside. Government didn't want it to lead that business, right? So this is what the India needs to learn and support every manufacturer from the backside, push them, and then let them explore their entrepreneur skills. Number two is, whatever is happening right now, the policy which are coming up, which is all Indian business centric.
Mm-hmm.
So India, we are talking about, India still has 450 gigawatt of opportunity.
Yeah.
So the factory cannot set up as a 450 gigawatt,
mm-hmm.
looking at the 450. If I want to set up my factory, I need to have access to the global market.
Right.
My standards, my quality, my quantity has to be as per the global demand.
Mm-hmm.
Then only I'll be able to make myself as a global factory. So that approach needs to be changed. Let's not look at 450 gigawatt. Let's look at 4,500 gigawatt, which is there in world. Then only the China did the same thing. India, we do not need to reinvent the wheel. Let's learn from the success story.
Okay, sir. Now that we are seeing that the raw material prices have been fluctuating, there is a lot of pricing concern. So what is the pricing roadmap of your company?
See, basically, the solar business is driven on pricing, definitely raw material pricing, and which is very dynamic.
Mm-hmm.
So there is no such roadmap that anyone can envisage or forecast. It is, the major component is a solar cell,
mm-hmm.
where the India has, we are at present, for next 2 years, we will be totally dependent on China, no doubt about that. Indian companies are gearing up with the manufacturing of their cell line, but it will take it to its own time to support the supply demand for all the manufacturers. So there will be definitely dependency on China.
Mm-hmm.
Other raw material also the Indian companies are developing. So it's a 2 years transition phase where there will be a lot of uncertainty and fluctuation on pricing. But basically, you know, this is temporary. Like, you know, the major reason for the increase in price is the disturbance in supply chain.
Right.
And the logistic cost. These are the two major reasons. I think in another 5 to 6 months that will get settled down,
mm-hmm.
and then again we will be have advantage of a competitive price again in the market.
The government of India has set a target of 450 gigawatt renewable energy power by the year 2030.
Yeah.
Do you think it is achievable?
It is achievable. Why not?
Okay.
India has that opportunity. India has that land bank. Only thing is, you know, we have to change approach. See, like the target was 30 gigawatt a year, but we have never been able to cross 10 gigawatt. We must find out those reasons. Major reasons are too much of dependency on the government incentives, too much of dependency on the policy making, because, you know, we are dealing with the power. Power is controlled by the government. Electricity is controlled by government. So there is definitely, it requires some privatized approach and reduce the dependency on the government. Need fast clearance of a land bank and everything, because solar is a land dependent business. So there are a lot of delays on that front also. So India can do 50 gigawatt a year, no doubt about it. Only thing is that overall mindset needs to be changed and less dependency on government.
Okay. What is your view on the basic custom duty which will be applicable from April next year as per the announcement by the
minister? We are, as a manufacturer, we are looking forward to this implementation of BCD for quite some long time. and we are late, definitely I would say, but I think we are looking forward to have this BCD from April. Advantage with having BCD will be, you know, the faster expansion and the growth, the confidence building in Indian manufacturer. Up till now, there was a lack of confidence in Indian manufacturer because of the import, the support to the import, of modules, the pressure of developers on a government to let them import the low-cost modules. So basically, this will definitely encourage Indian manufacturer expand fast and become Indian manufacturer also very competitive compared to China.
Any final remarks for the industry from your end?
We have a long way to go. Days are good. We have already seen a lot of challenges in last 1.5 years. And I think with new hope, new opportunity, India will conquer the world market. And don't give up. Keep working. And make your business model which is independent, not dependent on the government incentives, government policies. If you can make this happen, I think no one can stop India.
So as we are aware that Solex has been recognized under India's 500 best brands. So would you like to inform us more about it?
Yeah, in fact, as a Solex, we have been working so hard for a long time. Practically, our promoters are in business for almost 25 years in renewable energy. Started as a solar water heating system, and now, you know, we have taken up a big leap into the solar manufacturing and projects. So, recognizing our efforts, we are selected as one of the top 500 brands, all industry put together in India. So, it is a great honor for us, and definitely, like Solex as a organization. Solex as one of the entity, it is a great achievement for all the team members in Solex, and this is not an ordinary achievement. This is something which is very rare in terms of the solar industry. So thank you very much for all the support and enthusiasm.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.